We have discussed in our previous class regarding Euclid's division lemma, where we have learned how to find the HCF of two numbers. We had also dealt with the examples, example number 1, 2, and 3, using Euclid's division lemma and example. Continuing with the same system, we will be moving on to the example number 4. That is, a strict seller has 420 consumer fees and 130 consumer fees. She wants to stack them in such a way that each stack has the same number and they take up the least area of the tree. What is the number that can be placed in each stack of the stacks? We have two different types of fees, consumer fees and consumer fees. And we have to stack them in such a way that each state have equal numbers from both types of purpose. Equal number from both types of purpose, that means we need the highest common factor of the two given number of purpose in each state. So, according to Euclid's division lemma, we know that highest common factor, HCF of two numbers, can be found on by Euclid's division. Method. So we will be applying that method to find the total number of burpees in each state taken from both two different types of burpees. Since the number Raju burpees 420 and Madhav burpees 130, the bigger number is 420, so as per you get A is 420 and B is 130. According to Euclid's division lemma, we know A is equals to BQ plus R, 0 less than equals to R less than. We have taken A to be 420. So 420 is equals to B is equals to 130. And on dividing 420 by 120, we get quotient as 3 and remainder as 30. So writing in the format of Euclid's division lemma, 420 is equals to 130 into 3 plus 30. Since remainder is not 0, so we will have to continue the process of Euclid's division lemma. Now the divisor becomes the dividend and the remainder becomes the divisor. Again, if you divide the dividend with the divisor, you get the quotient as 4 and remainder as 10. Again, remainder is not 0, so we have to continue the method. Again, the divisor becomes the dividend and the remainder becomes the divisor. And again, continuing with the same, if you divide 30 by 10, that is 3 and remainder becomes 0. So when remainder becomes 0, the last divisor is the HCF of the two numbers that we have taken. That is why HCF of 420, 130 is 10. That means she has to stack 10 number of counter type of burpees in each stack. Moving further to exercise 1.1. Question number 1. Using Euclid's division algorithm, find the HCF of 135 and 225. Comparing with the Euclid's division lemma or algorithm, whatever you say, we can say A is equals to 225 and B is equals to 135. In order to find the HCF of these two numbers, we will have to follow the Euclid's division algorithm. So, according to Euclid's division lemma, we know A is equals to BQ plus R. Here A is 225 and B is 135. In order to get Q and R, we will have to divide A by B. So, 225 divided by 135, 1 is 135 and remainder is pictures can be written as 225 is equal to 135 into 1 plus 9. The remainder is not 0. So division algorithms should be calculated. So now the divisor becomes the dividend and the remainder becomes the divisor. And divide the dividend by the divisor once again. 135 divided by 90, this is 190, and this is 45. So this can be written as 90 into 1 plus 45. Again, the remainder is not 0. So we haven't reached the SCF of 2 numbers. So let us continue. The divisor becomes the dividend, and the remainder becomes the divisor. And when you divide the dividend by the divisor, the quotient is 2, and the remainder becomes 0. Now we have got the remainder to be 0. So the last divisor would be my HCF. So we can say HCF of 225 comma 135, these two numbers is 45. Bit 2. We need to find the HCF of 196 and 38220. Using Euclid's division algorithm. As we noted in the previous bit number 1, same way we will be solving bit 2 and bit 3. So here A is 38220 and B is 196. And as according to Euclid's division lemma, we have A is equal to B plus. So we need to divide A by B in order to get Q and R. Let us continue. The reason 38220. We divide it by 196. This is 196. 6 8 1 2. Then 196 into 9 54 5 81 86 8 1764. This is 1764. 9. This is 8 9. This is 5 9 9 2. So the first step itself. So this step only be written as 38220 is equal to 196 into 195 plus 0. In the first step itself, we got the remainder to be 0. So the divisor becomes our HCF. So we can say HCF of 38220 comma 196 is 196. Moving on to the bit 3. Again, we have to find the HCF of 867 and 225 using Euclid's division algorithm. Here we can take A is equal to 867 and B is equal to 225, as the larger number is 867. That is why it is taken as A. So continuing to follow Euclid's division lemma, according to Euclid's division lemma, A is equal to B plus R. That means A should be divided by B in order to get the quotient Q and R. So let us divide 867 by 225. 867 divided by 225. So this is 3. 675. 2 and 9. 192. So we can write 867 is equal to 225 into 3 plus 192. The remainder is not 0, so division algorithm would be continued. So divisor becomes dividend and remainder becomes the divisor. divides it into 1 plus 23. Again, the remainder is not the same. So the divisor becomes the dividend and the remainder becomes the divisor, and we need to divide the dividend with the divisor. So 192 divided by 33, and this is divisor 165.7. And 23 into 5 plus 27. And 33 is equal to 27 into 1 plus 6. Then 27 is equal to 6 into 4 plus 3. Then 6 is equal to 3 into 2 plus 0. So that's CF of 867 and 225 is 3. In some of the books of NCERT, there was a printing mistake regarding this 255 and 225. That is why I am solving both the cases. Previously, I have solved to find the HCF of 867 and 225 using Euclid's Simpson algorithm, and secondly we will be solving to find the HCF of 867 and 255 using the same division algorithm. So here A is equal to 867, B is equal to 255 using Euclid's division algorithm. We are according to Euclid's division lemma, A is equal to B cube plus R. Here we can write 867 is equal to 255 into. Now we have A, we have B, we will be dividing A by B in order to get Q and R. So let us divide. 867 divided by 255, and this is 3 is 15, 5. Then 3 by 15 is 16. And 1 is 765. This is 2 0 1 1 0. So 265 into 3 plus 1 0 2. The remainder is not 0. So let's get into the algorithm. Now 255 is equal to 1 0 2. The divisor becomes the dividend, and the remainder becomes the divisor. So again, divide the dividend by the divisor to get Q and R. If you divide 255 by 102, this is 204, and this is 51. So you can write 102 into 2 plus 51. Remainder is not 0, so we will have a continuous series of algorithm. So divisor becomes dividend, and remainder becomes the divisor. If you divide 102 by 51, so the quotient will be 2 and the remainder becomes 0. So as soon as we get the remainder to be 0, the last divisor becomes our HCF of the 2 given the first. So now we can say that HCF of 867 over 255 is 51. Question number 2, exercise 1.1. Show that any positive odd integer is of the form 6q plus 1. Or 6q plus 3 or 6q plus 5, where q is some integer. Same type of question we have solved in previous examples, example number 2 and example number 3. Same way we would be calculating this question also. First of all, we need to assume an integer, the integer that is to be checked whether it is even or odd. And I have told you previously also, look through the questions very minutely, and these three, according to Euclid's division lemma, it will give me the value of B, and the value of B can be taken here as 6. So we need two things. One is we need to assume an integer, and second, B is equal to 6 has been taken from the question itself. So Let us begin. Let us assume any positive integer a and b equals to 6. It should satisfy the Euclid's Chiasson law. So satisfying Euclid's Chiasson law, a is equals to b plus r, 0 less than equals to r less than 6 less than b, the most important condition of the Euclid's Chiasson law. Now, all substituting this value in the Euclid's Chiasson law, we can have substituting b equals to 6, we have a is equals to 6 cubed plus half, and the condition becomes 0 less than equals to r less than 6. I had told you previously also during the example time that r can take as much as number of values, the value of b has. Now here the value of b is 6. So b will get 5 values of r. And what are those 5 values? R can be greater than or equals to 0. So equals to 0 means 0. Greater than 0 means 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. It should be less than 6. So these are the 6 values that R have. Or substituting these values in the given equation, the lemma will reduce to. Lemma reduces. A is equals to 6 cube plus 0, and as I told you earlier, plus 0 is not required, so you can write A is equals to 6 cube, A is equals to 6 cube plus 1, A is equals to 6 cube plus 2, A is equals to 6 cube plus 3, A is equals to 6 cube plus 4, and A is equals to 6 cube plus 1. 6 cases. Out of these 6 cases, we have to find only those cases which are actually odd, what we are asked in the question. And in the previous class, I have told you, if we get 2 as a factor in any of the equations, that means it is even, and if you are not getting the factor, then it is odd. If you move on each of the conditions, here you can take 2 power, this becomes 3 cube. Here you cannot take common because this is 6 cube, a multiple of 2 plus 1. Multiple of 2 means even, and if you add 1 to it, it becomes odd, as I told you earlier. Again, here you can get 2 common, this is 3 cube plus 1. Here you cannot get common, again, here you can get common, this is 3 cube plus 2, and so on. And last also, this is a multiple of 2, and this is an odd number, added to an even number makes it an odd number. Let us name it as equation number 1, equation number 2, equation number 3, equation number 4, equation number 5, and equation number 6. Out of the 6 equations, equation number 2, 4, and 6 are odds because they do not have a multiple of 2, and 1, 3, and 5, since 2 can be derived from it, so 2 becomes a factor of it, which makes it an even number. So 1, 3, and 5, these are even positive integers, and 2, 4, and 6 are odd positive integers. So from 2, 4, and 6, we can say that every or any positive or integer is of the 6 cube plus 1 or 6 cube plus 3 or 6 cube plus 5 or some value of cube. Hence, number 3. An army contingent of 616 members is to march behind an army band of 32 members. incorporated. The groups, both the groups, the two groups are to march in same number of columns. When we are talking about same number of columns, means number of members of the band and number of members in the army contingent, so to say. In order to make it same, we need to find the HCF of the two numbers, the highest common factor, into how many equal parts they can be divided. A number which can divide both the members of army contingent, that is 616, and army band, that is 22. That means we need to find the HCF of these two numbers. Following the Euclid's division law, we can take the higher numbers as A. So A is equal to 616 and B is equal to 22 members. It is again told that the two groups are to march in the same number of columns. That means we are finding number of columns, and that number of columns will have same members. So according to Euclid, according to division A is equal to B plus. And since we are moving to find the HCF of the two numbers using Euclid's division lemma, we need to follow the Euclid's division algorithm. So 616 is equal to 22 into, that means the highest number is to be divided by the smallest number. So let us divide 616 by 32 in order to get our quotient and limit. So this is 1 32 9 296, and 9 18 and 28. So 32 into 19 plus 8. The remainder is not zero. So according to Euclid, the algorithm should be continued. So the divisor becomes the dividend, and the remainder becomes the divisor in order to obtain new values for Q and R. So let's divide 32 by 8. This is 4 32, and this becomes 6. So we can say 32 is equal to 8 into 4 plus 0. Now, since we got the remainder to be 0, the last divisor is considered to be the HCF. So we can say this 8 is the HCF. So HCF of 616 comma 32 is 8. That means the two groups are to march in 8 number of columns. So the two groups are to march in 8 columns. Question number 4. Use Euclid's division lemma to show that square of any positive integer is of the form 3m or 3m plus 1 for some integer. Now in this question, we need to find the square of a positive integer. There should be a positive integer. We have to square that, and the value of that square number is of the form 3m or 3m plus 1. But before, let me recall you something. First of all, we have to assume a positive integer. And while observing the total question, I have told you earlier also that this 2 will give me my values of b. So we can take b is equal to 3. So let us start. Let us assume any positive integer a and b equals to 3, as we have discussed. Satisfying Euclid's division lemma. A is equal to b cube plus r, with the condition that r is greater than or equal to 0 or less than b. Then substituting b is equal to b equals to 3, we have A is equals to 3q plus r. 0 less than is equals to r less than 3. We have substituted the value of b in both the cases, here also and there also. And we have got the condition that r will be greater than or equals to 0 but less than 3. So r can give the values 0, 1, and 2. The lemma reduces all applying the values of r is equals to 0, 1, 2 in the given equation. The lemma reduces to a is equals to 3q, a equals to 3q plus 1, and a is equals to 3q plus 2. Now we have got that positive integer. Which positive integer? That was mentioned in the question. Any positive integer which we assume to be a, and that a can take these three values. The square of these three values should be of the form 3m or 3m plus 1, as it was mentioned in the question that the square of any positive integer is of the form 3m or 3m plus 1. So we have got the positive integer and we have the square. So we have three cases to be solved. First case 1. Well, a is equals to 3q. We have to square the number. So we can write a square is equals to 3q square. This is equals to 9q square. And if you take off 3 as a factor, we can write 3q square, which could be written as 3m, where the value of m is 3q square. That is the condition that can be applied. The m can take the values of 3q square. So m is equal to 3q square. So a square is of the form 3m, as what was implied in the question. Then case 2. Well, a is equal to 3q plus 1. Again, we will have to square it. Because we want the square of the numbers. So this is 3q plus 1 whole square. This is of the form a plus b whole square. A plus b whole square means a square plus 2ab plus b square. So this can be written as 9q square plus 6q plus 1. But we don't need it this form. We need it in the form of m. That should be 3m plus 1 or 3m. If we observe this, we can take out 3 as common and this will be written as 3q square plus 2q plus 1. And we can again write this one as 3m plus 1, and here the value of m can be taken as 3q square plus 2q. We assume this value of 3q square plus 2q to be m. In case 3. Well, a is equal to 3q plus 2. Again, squaring both sides, we have 3q plus 2 whole square. And applying the identity, a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. This could be written as 9q square plus 12q plus 4. But we need to take 3 as a common. From these two, we can take 3. Let us try how to take. If you take 3 common here, this becomes 3q square plus 4q plus 4. And if we assume this to be m, so this becomes 3m plus 4. But this is completely wrong. Because the remainder, the value of the remainder cannot exceed the value of the divisor. That means whatever we have assumed was somewhere. And also we could not take this. We have to keep this in mind. So we will be removing this. So what will we be doing? We can write this one as 9q square plus 12q, and we will break it in the form of 3. Now we will be taking these 3 terms to take off. Now we can take this one as 3 as common. This is 3q square plus 4q plus 1 plus 1. This can be written as 3m plus 1. This is going to be m, where the m can take the values 3q square plus 4q plus 1. In all the three cases, if we observe the final result, in the first case we got as 3m, in the second case we got 3m plus 1, in the third case also we got 3m plus 1 for different values of m at different cases. Observing all the three cases, we can say thus the square of any positive integer is of the form 3m or 3m plus 1 for any value of n. Question number 5. Using Euclid's prism law, we need to show that the cube of any positive integer is of the form 9m or 9m plus 1 or 9m plus 8. The previous question also, it was almost same. In place of cube, it was square. The square of any positive integer with some forms. Here, the cube of any positive integer of the form 9m or 9m plus 1 or 9m plus 8. Here, there is an exception. In all the previous questions, I told you that our this values will give me my value of b. But here in this special case, since we are talking about q, we would be finding such factor of 9 whose cube is divisible by 9. A factor of 9 whose cube would be divisible by 9. And that factor is 3. If you take 3, the cube of 3 is 27 and it is always divisible by 9. So let us assume, first of all, a positive integer a. And here, as I told you, we will take b is equal to 3, satisfying Euclid's division lemma, a is equal to b plus r, with the condition that r is greater than or equal to 0, but less than b. Substituting b is equal to 3. Substituting b equals to 3. We have a is equal to 3q plus r with the condition that r is greater than or equal to 0, less than 3. So r can take the values 0, 1, and 2. Three values of r, and on substituting the values of r, the lemma reduces to a is equal to 3q, b is equal to 3q plus 1, a is equal to 3q plus 1, and a is equal to 3q plus 2. We have three cases for a single positive value a. That means a can take three values, 3q, 3q plus 1, and 3q plus 2. So we need to check all the three cases to find or to show that the cube of that positive integer will be of the form 9m or 9m plus 1 or 9m plus 8. So let us move one by one. Case 1. When a is equal to 3, we are talking about cube of that positive number. So cubing both sides, a cube is equal to 3 cube 1 cube. This becomes 27 q cube, and if you take out 9 as a factor, this becomes 3 q cube, and this is 9m, where m can take the value as 3 q. This is case 1. Case 2. When a is equal to 3 q plus, again cubing both sides, a cube is equal to 3q plus 1 whole cube. Now here we can use the identity a plus b whole cube, which is equal to a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube. So this is equal to 27 q cube plus 27 q square plus 9 q plus. On expanding 3q plus 1 whole cube, b figured 27q cubed plus 27q squared plus 9q plus 1. And if you take common from this first part, what will be taking common? 9, because we need to prove it's the form of 9. So this will be 3q cubed plus 3q squared plus q plus 1, which can be written as 9m plus 1. Here m takes the value as 3q cubed plus 3q squared plus q. That is q. Well, a is equals to 3 cube plus 2. Again, cubing both sides, a cube is equals to 3 cube plus 2 whole cube. We will be expanding 3 cube plus 2 whole cube with identity a plus b whole cube, that is a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube. So this becomes 27 cube plus. This becomes 54 q squared plus 36 q plus. Considering these three terms, if you take 9 as common, this becomes 3 q plus 6 q squared plus 4 q plus 8. If we consider this one as m, we can write 9m plus 8. Here m will take the value 3q cubed plus 6q squared plus 4q. From case 1 and 2 and 3, if you observe, in the case 1 when a was equal to 3q, we got the form 9m. And in second and third case, when the value of a, there are 3q plus 1 and 3q plus 2, we got two different forms. For a is equals to 3q plus 1, we got 9m plus 1, and for a is equals to 3q plus 2, we got 9m plus 2. So as per our question, the cube of any positive integer is of the form 9m that we have got in case 1, then 9m plus 1 we have got in case 2, then 9m plus 8 we have got in case 3. So thus we can say, that the cube of any positive integer is of the form 9m or 9m plus 1 or 9m plus 8 for any value of m. For any value of